are a top-tier freaky pet that you just can't help but be mesmerized by, and their active color-changing abilities are a picture-perfect example of chemistry going hand-in-hand with evolution. Believe it or not, these oddball reptiles are actually working with a different chemical toolbox than cephalopods and their other color-changing counterparts. Today, we're looking at how they work their magic and how it's inspired scientists to invent new up-and-coming technologies. One thing that really stands out about chameleons is that they always have this suspiciously chilled out look on their faces. But that's not all when it comes to bizarre features. Their feet are zygodactylous, with three toes facing forward and two going the opposite direction. They also have monocular vision, so their eyes can move about and focus independently from one another. If you've ever seen a chameleon eat, then you also know about their amazing projectile tongues, but the cream of the crop of their freaky features is gonna have to be their psychedelic skin. Chameleons have the ability to actively change both their color and their brightness. While it's often thought to be used for just camouflage, scientists believe there are two other fundamental uses, the first being intraspecific communication, and the second being a means for thermoregulation. Because chameleons are cold-blooded, they need sunlight to heat themselves up to get their metabolism running. By controlling how bright or dark they are, they can better regulate how much heat they take on. And while their color changing may not seem to stand out from cephalopods and the others, they do have a chemical mechanism that sets them apart from the crowd. Cephalopods and chameleons have color-changing cells called chromatophores that carry pigments inside of them that can be displayed at will. However, there's a big difference between the two. The chameleon's version comes equipped with an advanced layer of nanoscience. This colorful little guy is known as a panther chameleon, and its skin can exhibit a range of these specific colors. Here's where it gets interesting. Only these specific colors can be displayed by the typical pigments released by chromatophores. So where do they get those whites, blues, and greens? From unique cells called iridophores. Iridophores aren't filled with pigments, but instead with tiny little structures of nanocrystals that can produce iridescent blue light in their resting state. The chameleons can excite these crystals, rearranging them into a different structure that changes the wavelengths of light that they absorb and reflect. This turns them from blue to white. We're not sure exactly how chameleons control their iridophores, but we suspect they're working with either neural or hormonal mechanisms. And while some cephalopods are packing iridophores too, the chameleons are the ones that have truly mastered them. Inside the panther chameleon's skin are several layers of different colored chromatophores. The top layer contains a mix of yellow xanthophores and red-orange erythrophores. The bottom layer has brown, melanin-bearing melanophores. Mixed into the top layer of red and yellow chromatophores are your iridescent light-generating iridophores. And in between these two layers, you find reflective iridophores. The chameleon changes its skin color by adjusting the pigments released by their chromatophores, and then takes things one step further by using those iridophores to change the way we perceive the chromatophores' pigments. For example, the panther chameleon can produce a green color because those resting nanocrystals reflect blue light, so pair that with the yellow pigment up above and your eyes perceive green. Then when excited, the blue becomes white, which will make the yellow xanthophores stand out more prominently. This use of nanocrystals is so ingenious that it even inspired scientists in China to come up with their own active camouflage nanotechnology. Instead of iridophores, these researchers created tiny gold nanoparticle domes that they housed in cells filled with a silver ion-loaded gel. By sending different charges through the gel, silver ions will tack onto or break off of the gold nanodomes, which changes the wavelengths of light they absorb and reflect. The team attached this system to cameras and can currently change the active color of the cells to red, green, and blue. So what do you think? If this technology keeps advancing, will we ever see active camouflage as advanced as the predators? Let us know down in the comments. Before you go, we'd like to invite you to check out America from Scratch. America from Scratch is a new PBS Digital Studios series that asks, what might the US be like if it was founded today? It tackles some big questions. Should 12-year-olds be allowed to vote? What if there were no states? Do we even need a president? It's like the best civics class ever. Subscribe to America from Scratch at the link in the description below. Thanks. Hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, and we'll see you again soon.